Afternoon. Welcome back. I was excited all day to get playing, so let's waste no time. At the end of yesterday's stream, we had just gotten to the point where I changed my build, and so I am now using Hurricane, and it does a lot more damage. Duration will go up by 1 second every level, and just over 300 damage every level. And it also looks like the mana cost only goes up by 4. So basically, if I get 10 levels on this, I'll double my damage, which is pretty significant, right? Because right now it's level 12. Oh yeah, and we got kind of lucky with this. So our Merc now has Conviction Aura. Also, are we getting the magic and lightning damage? I think the way it works is you have to have another source of those damages. This gives magic, so we do get the magic damage from this, but presumably not the lightning. Unless we wind up getting something else that gives. So, what we're going to do, we're going to do a couple runs of the Dark Wood on Players 8. This is to farm up some kills so that I can get some poster fragments. Hopefully we can complete another poster or two, and then I think we tread on to the Tamo Highland and probably farm there a little bit. I'm thinking we basically work on leveling up, getting some drops, and then around level 150, we'll probably try Andariel. Just because I don't really have a good, like, main skill yet. I'm just using Hurricane. And it's good for clear, but it's not going to be good against Andariel. So right now, this is kind of how it plays. Taking all the cards. I should have grabbed a gem. I didn't even see that it was a gem shrine in time. You know, what'll be great is when we actually get a skill to use in between hurricanes. So, Cold Wave might actually be the contender. I think I have, a Cold Wave Torch. Berks. So these are cool. Yeah, Lycanthropy is 10 extra seconds. So we have a 3.5 minute werebear right now. But it gives 100% life. I mean, that is pretty significant. So if we do that, 62 and 89. Yeah, I mean, that's like 4,000 life and 4,000 defense. And I mean, not that the damage increase matters, but my attack damage is now in the thousands. If I could actually hit anything. Seems like my attack rating is... I don't know, I should be able to hit those guys. Dude, I am getting, like, stun-locked, though. There we go. Hey, welcome back, Andrago. We are just getting started on farming with the new skill. actually doing things now. I guess if we're just going for kills, I don't feel any particular need to take out Treehead. Yeah, I mean, it feels way better. Like, this is just so much faster. Like, what is it? Enemies take damage every second? Yeah, I actually just got this, like, during this run. And so I was like, eh, whatever. It's, as you can see, it's a bunch of life, damage, and defense. And that's... the life is really nice. It takes me from, like, 9,000 to 13,000, so pretty significant. This is also players 8, so that's why stuff isn't dying in one hit. I'm pretty sure on players 1, everything just dies in one hit. Like, the damage isn't insane, but 3,000 damage is good enough. I also, I got this, which is really sweet. I don't know if you remember that from yesterday, but Merc has a conviction. And that's really good. Oh, yeah. Yeah, well, it was a good idea. Turns out having an Act 1 Merc with Conviction is pretty good. You know what I could do is I could get an Act 2 Merc. Have an armor with conviction when equipped and wind up getting 2 auras that way. I don't really know if an Act 1 Merc is actually the best for me. So, we kinda gotta test it out. I'm gonna reduce the players to 5. And we'll do repair durability. Yeah, I think I want that. I'm gonna do Black Marsh on players 5. Yeah, Act 1 Merc is really helpful for clear, especially right now. I mean, if I do lean more into reanimates, Act 2 seems good. Because that's just another bonus aura. Alright, we'll do Black Marsh now. Well, I guess these guys have pretty good resists. Oh, another boss wyvern. This will give us a lot of experience when we start killing stuff. Alright, here's my cursor. Look at that. Yep. So, is this gonna be an entire level off of that pack of wyverns? No, not quite. Take the Grand Charm. It's this one. Yeah, that's not very good. I don't care. Bob's Smashy. We got Chilling Armor on a torch. I think that's the only torch we've gotten. This run, at least. I don't know how I picked up a random torch. Yeah, this is the slain monster's rest in peace. Actually, but maybe I re-enabled it when I took monster affixes off. I really don't remember, honestly. Pretty sure Experience Shrine is 50% experience, and that is significant. I do want to see this belt. Only on level 26. Okay, then I don't really care. You know, what I should really do is if I'm only farming for kills, I should just play on players 1. But I suppose the reality is I should also be farming for drops. There's no reason to do all of this on players 1 if players 5 is only marginally slower. We got another wyvern boss. My attacks are so slow. I'll wind up picking up rares more when they are level 99. Heck, I'll probably even pick up magicals when they're level 99. But for right now, I don't think that that seems important. Dagger to Blade Star, that's... I mean, if I were an assassin, I guess. Blade Stars are like a new claw that is added in Zael, and they're just claws, but better. Also, they're four sockets, so they can, or they're four slots, so they can be four socketed. So, I mean, that's better. I don't remember if I changed Demon Box outputs to be level 99. I might have left them at level 99. I just don't remember. Those are probably safe, because by the time you get demon keys, you know, you're not like level 5 anymore. I like those volcanoes. Like, they seem to do pretty decent damage. It's like a bunch of small hits. I'll drop it down to players 3. And we'll go Cloister. Now I feel like Warped One should be okay on players 3. Because I deal more damage now. And I feel like I had less DPS, but maybe I wasn't trying on players 3. I don't know. Give a whirl. If this doesn't go at least like reasonably well, I can always tone it down. But from what I remember when I was playing with the random monsters previously, yeah, these guys got full reviews. Players 3 was fine. And there's like no other scary monsters for the rest of Act 1. Nothing noteworthy, at least. Yeah, I don't actually do a lot of damage to Warp 1s. It takes quite a while for me to take them down with just Hurricane. I also just, like, can't hit them apparently. I'll take the Flawless. Can't wait to get more cast speed and hit recovery and not feel like these animations are painfully slow. Ooh, a bunch of Stygian dolls. Again, these guys are great because they can drop full reduce. Like that. I'll be using, well, I could use like a zeal or something. Yeah, that's cool. It's good damage. It's cool that it's F. All right. One thing that's kind of cool about bear form and wolf form and really all state-based transformations is if you take damage that would kill you, instead you get taken to 1 HP and untransformed. So I've actually had it where bear form saves me because instead of dying, I just get hit down to 1. And then you can just bear form again and the same thing will happen. I mean, of course, that doesn't help when you're fighting a ton of monsters that are hitting you really quickly. But, like, against a single really hard-hitting monster, it can be really helpful. Alright, I think we're almost at 10,000 kills. We're gonna start moving forward from the outer cloister, rather. I do want to progress now. I think we can. Like, I think we're at a point now where it's fine. Our damage is good enough. I have 14,000 HP. And, like I said, I don't think there's really anything else. Oh, skill token of Hurricane. I don't think there is really anything else in Act 1 that is particularly scary. What do we get? Another midriff? What is she using? Why did my inventory... Oh, she died! I was like, why did my merc inventory just shut? My mercenary died. Yeah, warp clones are no joke. I do have slain monsters rest in peace. So, I mean, I guess that is a small favor. Right, it's something. Regardless, we are just gonna go back real quick. Okay, so this isn't very good. The Blessed Meteors when struck is cool, but it has not triggered yet, to my knowledge. So I think we're going to go with Kyra's Midriff. Faster run walk is really all I care about, but it's also two-socketed. I guess this is two-socketed too, but we'll go with this guy for now. You know, the other thing I could do is buy some merc gear. Right, like these gloves are real bad. Maybe I'll buy new gloves and hope for some merc gloves. I could buy a new bow. This isn't really doing much, especially because as mercenaries level up, they use regular attack less and less. So it's just less and less relevant. Alright, so now we gotta do something with all these. Alright, so here's a little... Oh god, I forgot about all those. Okay, what else do we have? We have any more threes? Four, five, six, seven, eight. Joker's there. And then these are all twos. Yeah. So we'll get this sorted real quick. It won't take me very long. All stuff I don't care about. 5 to 10 HP is too low. Yeah, 40 to 20 is fine. This is like really good, but I guess I don't actually care about it. So there's that, there's that, there's that. That's fizz. That's fizz. actually care about that one. We do that, and then where we have our set items, we're gonna put that on page previous. This is where I put full rejuves, because if you do any set item and a full rejuve potion, it jewelizes that set item. And so you can, like I could turn this into a jewel, which is actually kind of sweet. 30% faster run walk is not nothing. Or like this, just getting the poison length reduction as a jewel. So all of these can be jewelized. Jewels do not get the bonus stats at item level 99, so that at least isn't super relevant. This does mean that I can start working on my Skillpedia, though, because I think it, like, having the Hurricane here, Hurricane is really good. It will be really good, and I guess unless... Yeah, all things being equal, their damage seems to be about the same. The most important thing is their radius, which is also the same, and will not scale. So, yeah, that's a pretty good one. And not what I meant to do, but that's okay. Oh, we do have the Frozen Orb, too. Frozen Orb and Cold Wave. What I'm going to do really quick is I'm just going to check on their damage. And the way I'm going to do that is by starting new characters. I think I actually do want to keep that. I don't have a Arcana's piece yet. So many Cathins. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Whatever. It's fine. I think, yeah. So we might do Cold Wave, we might do Hurricane. Is there anything else here? Well, we're gonna do Hurricane. We might do Cold Wave or Frozen Orb, so I'll double check on those. And then I think we're gonna just go all of the buffs. Battle Command is the plus one skills one, right? I don't actually think that that's worth it. Okay, so I wanna check Assassin Cold Wave and Sorceress Frozen Orb. And so, Frozen Orb is 40 to 80 at level 1. And I don't know a way I would have to have something that gave O-Skill Frozen Orb in order to really test that, I suppose. Yeah, and that does not give a Sorceress O-Skill. Oh, and even if I did have something that gave Frozen Orb, it would require level 7. So, regardless, that is 40 to 80 damage at level 1. And what does Cold Wave look like?
Good day.
20 to 40. The thing about Cold Wave is it multi-hits. Right? Because it knocks enemies back. And, you know, actually the other thing I'm going to do. So that shows me that cold wave is worse in a vacuum, but I'm actually going to open up the text file. And check how their damage scales. Would be good for bossing. Yeah, I mean, Frozen Orb probably would be better for bossing, right? Because you can have a lot of the ice bolts hit the same monster. Okay. So, cold missiles. $10, $20, $30, $40, $50 per level is how it scales. So $10, $20, $30, $40, $50 for cold wave. And frozen orb. $8, $16, $24, $36, $48. So technically, while Frozen Orb does more damage at level 1, Cold Wave actually has slightly better scaling. So it's kind of a horse apiece. I don't want to put both of them on the... Yeah, and they have the same cold length. I don't want to put both of them on the... on the Skillpedia, just because I don't want to, like... It feels like I use one or the other, right? Like, I'm not going to be swapping between the two, so why bother having both of them on the Skillpedia? Would the other skill kind of not stun lock? So, unless I'm mistaken, every missile skill has a 33% chance of knocking back. And knockback is a stun, right? It's a mini stun as the monster is knocked back. So with Cold Wave, it can hit multiple times because it hits, and it, then if it knocks the enemy back, then it hits again, and blah, blah, blah. Frozen Orb can also knock back, but I guess I haven't played enough Frozen Orb, at least in the past couple years, to remember if its behavior is going to allow for nice multi-hitting, and especially if it's knocking back, is that going to matter? They're both terrible indoors, so I guess there's that. Maybe I just go with Frozen Orb, because I played Cold Wave on my Assassin, and I would like to do something different, so... I'll do it. I'll do Frozen Orb. We'll get Hurricane on there. I'll save the Cold Wave for a rainy day for some other character. And then, gosh, I just don't know the skills well enough, which is really sad. So, Chilling Armor is the better one? Is it the best one? Chilling Armor sends ice bolts. Okay, I think Shiver Armor is probably the best, right? Because it's just a freeze. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with Shiver Armor if I can get it. Yeah, okay, I am agreeing with you there. Shiver Armor is gonna be better. Chilling Armor is cool, but I don't think I'm a build that really wants it. Got a couple more of those. Oh, that's our second of Thiot. Let me just need his little feedies. And then I also want to double check. Okay, so yeah, battle orders is the one that we want. Battle command is just plus one level. Yeah. All right. Okay, so I mean, there's another level on Hurricane, which is kind of cool. And then we'll put Frozen Orb there. Gosh, that damage seems so low. And then we want to do buff, buff. Technically, also buff. Turned a two into a six. Yeah, I'm gonna use some kill counts, see what we can get. I do need to condense more of these. I want to get rid of the low suits and chain those up. And then I'm gonna keep swords, talons, and stars, because those are the good suits. Yeah, after this, we'll do some kill count. Don't know why I keep forgetting about that. We'll do 16 clubs as well. The other thing we could start doing, and I don't know if it's worth it, is doing the 3-to-1s, I think. So that might be worth it. I don't know. Maybe not quite yet, because I probably want to get more higher numbers before I just start converting everything. Because, seven of a kind is really good, and it gives you this kind of stuff, but then you're always getting the same stats. You're gonna get some defense, you're gonna get some life, and you're gonna get some all resists alongside the all skills. Whereas different different hands, right, different poker hands are going to give you different things. I have this this whole page here with the ones that I've done. And so, like, you can get ones that have just straight up damage reduction. You can get ones that have dual leech. You can get ones that give you life per level. You can get ones that give you, like, amplify damage on striking or poison explosion or firewall. So there's all sorts of different things. The seven of a kinds are always good. Especially like with the talons and stuff, but you're usually getting those same kinds of stats. Let me put that there, yeah. Okay. Let's use some kill count. Still got some left. Four assassin skills. Deadly strike, heal stamina, reduce vendor prices. Fire skill damage, max mana. Increased attack speed, max damage, 29 lightning absorb. Four sorceress skills, attacker takes damage of 29. Right, this is like our last one. Minus 35% target defense. Yeah, that's bad. Two barb skills, four max fire res. 266% enhanced damage. Well, that is quite irrelevant, even though it's a high number. So we got two of Elmo there. I think we finished up Lucy, right? Yeah, okay. I was like, I swear. And we finished up Kirby. Okay, we got some cast rate. Ooh, plus one vitality. Good stuff. We're probably gonna reroll that. Yep, we got the Kirby now. Cannot be frozen. I always like getting cannot be frozen somewhere. So that's good, I guess. We'll put those there. I'm not gonna bother trying to complete those really. We have the middle of Kenny, yeah. So we'll put that there. I'm pretty sure we have the squirrel as well. We don't have the top of his head though. Do we have two? No, that's two Pocahontas heads. No. What's what? Oh, this is like Timon. I think. I guess I don't know. yeah, right? Like that? Yeah, and then he's got a feet. He's got feet. So we'll put those there. And then do I have Don't I have the bot? Yeah, I have the bottom of Bob the Tomato. Cool. We'll put that there. And then do I have Mufasa? Yeah, I have two Mufasa. I need the top of his head. And Do I have the monkey guy? No. Okay. Okay. That's where we're at. Like, that's fine. We got two posters. What I am going to do is, like, okay, this one's fine, right? This one's fine. This one... This one, I'm gonna re-roll. This one is fine. I wish it was cold skill damage. And this one I'm going to re-roll. So we'll re-roll a couple. So in order to re-roll, you make them small with a key, and then you re-expand them with a stamina potion. I mean, I think that's better. Also, the enhanced defense is kind of sweet. It almost makes werebear, well, the defense bonus at least is pointless, but it's still a good skill. Yeah, I mean, the life bonus is better. I think it was at like 300 with the other roll. Okay, so this is 312 life. Two max fire and four max, or two max poison and four max fire. This is fine. It's not anything insane. Yeah, look at those resists. Looking like a snack. So we're at 10,000 life without werebear, 15,000 with werebear, 18,000 with battle orders. Nice. Feels good. Did I feel like I was gonna do anything else? Maybe gamble some gloves? I'll do that. And I'm not gonna spend a ton of time doing this, but I wanna get something for my merc, and I wanna get something for me. How much are gauntlets? Yeah, they're not super expensive. Battle command on attack. That's weird. That's a lot of crushing blow. The energy is totally pointless on a mercenary, though, and I'm not gonna use them. Open wounds. A lot of lightning resist, wow. Cold skill damage, mana. I mean, I don't actually think I need mana. This doesn't cost a lot. These are giving me basically 150% extra gold. I don't think 8% cold skill damage beats 150% extra gold. Keep clicking the wrong thing. 33% faster cast rate might beat it, though. 3 to all skills definitely beats it. Yeah. So, hello, new gloves. Now do 4,000 with Hurricane. And, god, that damage is pathetic. 319. Goes up to 420. So I get, like, 35 damage per level. Well, I mean, it is what it is. Okay. Gotta get gloves for my Merc. Good crushing blow, but man after kill is pointless. Maximum lightning damage. Lightning skill damage, that's good, but really I would want what? Like magic skill damage for guided arrow or something? Those are actually bad. Chain lightning on striking. 104% enhanced damage. Damage, damage. That is a ridiculous amount of vitality. Too bad it does nothing on mercenaries. Holy crap. Yeah. Cast rate. I guess this is actually maybe okay, right? Because these are pretty bad. I don't mind losing out on the volcano, but this gives some fire damage. I guess that's actually irrelevant. I thought it was going to be more impactful damage-wise, and it's not. Whoops, I did not mean to buy that. 484% extra gold. We'll go with that. Especially, it has hit blinds target and damage reduction. Like, those are better. And I wanted to just drop those there. Okay, so we're back down to players one. And we're just gonna go. We want to beat Act 1. Because the very start of Act 2, which I had gotten to on my previous character, the very start of Act 2 has really good monster drops right away. So, that's not... So we're going to get to the start of Act 2 and then probably just farm for a little bit. So warped ones on players one will die in 2 hits. I mean, it doesn't do nothing. It just doesn't do insane damage. It's their level 87. Wow-wee. Yeah, maybe I'll do a level 87 Tall Charm. Or, no, we would really want that to be a magical. Yeah, re-rolling, I don't even know if you can really do. Yeah, that's kind of unfortunate. Oh, well. Because I don't think I actually want to use that charm specifically. It's just cool that it's level 87. Here we go. Oh, my Merc died again. Dude, what gives? I'm going to need to get, one of these kinds of things for my mercenary that just gives a ridiculous amount of resistances. Because I'll guarantee that's what killed her, with elemental damage. What's the duration on this? Ugh, only a minute and a half. It's kind of rough. Yeah. 19.5 is feeling pretty good. It's not the way. Nope, it's not. let me just walk. Stop trying to cast Frozen Orb. I mean, it's my fault for putting it on right-click, but... it's mostly just for sanity's sake. I don't hate, like, toggling between my hotkeys, but if I don't have to, I won't. Here we go. I'm also pretty sure that there's one of these levels that just doesn't spawn monsters. Since monsters were randomized, yeah, this might be it. There were a couple of levels that just, for whatever reason, randomized to zero monsters. Yeah. Drops are real bad on players one. I haven't even seen a drop. There we go. There's a drop. There's a double axe. There's a level up. There's a dead end. I also believe one of the catacombs levels is empty. I don't remember if it's one or two. I could be wrong, I might be misremembering. I also think it happens in Act 2. I think there's an area in Act 2 where there's just no monsters. Had to do with the randomizing, I assume. Oh, good, we can see where that is. So I can just... make my way over yonder. Alright, so here is Inner Cloister. Gonna ignore most of this stuff. This is a pretty good place to farm full rejuves, I imagine. Yeah, very close to 20,000 HP. Get her back in the game. And skull horn. Yeah, like I don't think I've ever seen that. Go bada bing bada boom. And I was gonna say we have Taz feet, right? No Taz body. Do I have 7 of anything? I have 7 talons and 7 swords. What's swords? Magic ring. Okay. So let's try this. If we get a good ring, it'll be nice to have something for our mercenary. Okay, it's a ring. All right. That seems fine to me. Now, this is responsible for less damage, but I just don't know if I can get rid of the Ancient's Call.
I might have to.
I guess she has Conviction now. So yeah, let's do that. Boom. In one fell swoop. Double her defense. Not quite double her life, but almost double her life. And then cap all of her resists. All right. She should not be dying anymore. Stygian dolls are the full rejuve drop-in ones. They also seem to drop quite a bit of gold. Although, I might just have a lot of gold fine now. Am I like a way higher level than her? Oh no, we're the same now. Mercs do tend to gain levels really quickly when there is a big difference between you and your mercenary. Probably why she gained a couple of levels so quick. A long warbow. Flame bellow. That's terrible. I mean, it's four socket, I guess. Like, that's cool. But ultimately, it's so easy to socket your stuff, like, mid and late game that, like, who really cares if a unique drops socketed? I do like it when uniques drop socketed early game, because that does free up a lot of options when you don't have, like, it takes, like, flawless and perfect gems and whatever to actually socket stuff. Oh. He's immune to cold. And it seems like my mercenary does not break the immunity. But that's okay. Well, I guess we must be leveling as well if she's leveling. Yeah, dark shapes are really good for drops. I'm pretty sure it's dark shapes that spawn in the very first area of Act 2. And they're the only enemies that spawn there. Which, ooh, that's a jack of swords. Which, just having those Wraith-type enemies being the only things that spawn there made it just so easy to farm. Like, poster fragments, jewels, charms, cards. So that'll be kind of the next step. I'm out of keys. Okay, I guess I need some keys. I do like blinding things. Should probably start picking up chipped gems again, so that I can have enough gems for, for some treasure card recipes. I'm really, really good at dropping my train of thought in the middle of a sentence. Definitely one of my more amazing talent. This might be worth using. It's just a bow with a bunch of damage. Yeah. Like, this is half my damage. We'll do that. That's fine. Tornado, Fend, Immolation Arrow, Holy Bolt. All pretty bad. We definitely need more all skills to make Werebear and Battle Orders feel better. I feel like you've got to have, like, probably a 5-minute duration minimum to have them feel actually castable. Or reliable, really, I suppose I should actually say. Like, you do not want to be in the middle of a fight like that. I just turned back into human form. You do not want to be in the middle of something and then revert to human form. Okay, I really want to get the waypoint on this level. Well, I guess I don't really care. Like, farming Andariel seems neat at all, but am I actually gonna do that? It's unlikely. If I come across the waypoint, I'll snag it. If I find the way down before that, I'll just ignore it. Charging me, bro. I hate monster charge. It's just annoying. Most monsters are annoying, though. Like, why should I even have to kill them to get their loot? Can't they just, like, give it to me? I'm clearly the stronger one here. Serpent Maguses can cheese off. Yeah, you can't charge me if I'm already against the wall, noob. Find a better strategy. Okay, so this is a dead end. Very cool. There's like... Oh, there is a good chance that it's over that way, actually. I was gonna say, there's no chance it's over here, right? And no, I don't think it could be. I think this is the end of the road here. These things are freaking annoying. I wonder if they have, like, cold resist? I don't know, it just seems like my damage is not very good against that guy, at least. Ugh. Well, I kind of went entirely the wrong way. So, I'm sorry, that's on me. Like, I'm obviously a scrub. Doesn't even know Diablo 2 map generation. Oh, okay, good. Here it is. Now, I think just to be safe, I am gonna check over here to the left because it is possible that the waypoint is just like right over here. And if it is, I do, yeah. Say if it is, I think I do want to snag it, because this is actually a really nice waypoint generation right next to the entrance to level 3. I guess you kind of have to go around, but it's fine. All things considered, it's about as close as it can possibly be. And then let's hope for a real close level 4. So this is not an empty level. That's fine. I feel like I probably have to go around like the outside edge, and so I wonder if this spawned more on like the left side. Well, okay, this seems to be the actual edge. Let's kind of run around here. I really do need to choose a jewel to start pumping because I want some run walk. I know Ultimate Gray Fox is in a different time zone from me. I guess you are as well. But usually, like, in the mornings, when it's morning for me, he's, like, done with work. So, I think I, like, talked to him and we're, like, 8 difference apart. Or 8 hours different. 8 hours apart? Whatever I'm trying to say. You're 6 ahead? Oh, so yeah, it's almost midnight for you. Yeah, I think for him, it's gotta be late as well. I mean, I do always post these on YouTube, but yeah, it's way more fun when people are watching live. Here we go. Okay, so that's not that bad. I just went way out of my way. So here's Cats level 4. This is a redone map. As far as I know, it's entirely custom. It's huge. I'm not going to explore all of it. I have the layout memorized. So we are just going to focus down Andariel because I don't care about the drops here. I just want to get to Act 2. Plus, we'll get tons of drops once we start Act 2. I want to see what level that is. Okay. Never mind. Let's put those in there. Because, I was going to say, I don't think we're at level 99 yet. Level 25 poison explosion with 55% poison skill damage, though, seems really cool. I believe that chance to cast skills do inherit your skill damage bonuses, because they act as if you have cast that skill. Thank you. Jack of Diamonds. Yabba dabba do. I will go up here because there is a chest and there's, I think, usually a boss in this area. Yeah. Boss. Ooh, an ace. That's pretty big. Yeah, I've played Valhalla. I don't remember, like, anything about it, though. Was Valhalla maybe one of the first ones that did, like, the gem words? I do recall Valhalla. Honestly, I kind of feel like I've probably played just about every mod. A cave full of Diablos. Yeah, stuff like that is always a little on the ridiculous side to me. I get why it's fun. Because, I mean, it's fun. In my mod, I'm going for a different approach. I'm going to try to emulate Path of Exile maps and have some, you know, late game areas that you can enter. Don't know if it matters, but my understanding is that you can bug Andariel's drops by exiting and rejoining the game like that. Kind of assume that doesn't work. I imagine most mods nowadays have fixed that, but, you know, I still do it. Okay, Oak Sage. Firebolt. Wow, all of those are just pretty bad. Let's drop off our elixirs here. Okay, we did put some things in our cube. I have two set items here. Berserkers and Nilabregas. And we want these here. We want to remove these. These are all uniques. Put the uniques in the stash. Another cabins. Another couple of demon boxes. There's where we had keys. Let's do the chokers. Those are the good ones. 2, 2, 2. That's a jack. six, three. Four, five, six. Seven, eight, nine, ten, jack. Queen, king, ace. Okay. Drop off those couple of chip gems I grabbed. Put that there. I always feel like this part is so slow and annoying and boring, but I mean, you gotta, right? You just gotta. Is that? There's the rest of Donkey. Yo, Donkey. 117% magic find. I think we will just keep that. One thing UGF said I should probably do is get rid of the magic find on the piggy bank, just because you don't need it if things can actually get magic find again. Uniques still grant zero magic find, so I don't know. I think that's kind of still fine, but I understand where he's coming from. Wow. We got really transported elsewhere. Yep, we have that part. Did we have another Fred Flintstone? I feel like I am starting to like mix up this playthrough and my Paladin playthrough, just in terms of like some of these items that I thought I had, but I am kind of realizing I don't. Okay, well, plop those down like that. Put that there. That is a third one of these two. It's just wild to have so many without the third piece. Any helm to druid pelt, I suppose we will keep that. No freeze to any jewel is actually probably worth holding on to. Yeah, I think that's going to be the mercenary jewel. The minus 20% attack speed actually kind of sucks. I don't love that, but you know, it's fine. We'll work with it. Put our perfect gems there, and we're gonna go. I'm gonna try players 8. I kind of assume it'll be fine. I have no idea if the dark shapes are gonna be scary or not, but starting with champions. Yeah, the only problem with that knockback is then they're out of hurricane range. And, like, that's not really what I want. Whereas hurricane isn't actually a missile, it's basically a holy fire. Experience is fine. So I need more damage, probably. Yeah. It's not bad, but yeah, like it takes all of, oh my god. That experience is kind of ridiculous. with this stuff. 63. Okay. Like, we might actually get something worth using. We'll put that there. Yeah, I mean, I can't complain about this experience. And yeah, we might get some good jewelry or good jewels. Getting a good jewel would be sweet. Those chip gems. I keep forgetting that you need a ton of chip gems for treasure cards. Like, every treasure card hand is going to require 7 chip gems to turn in. Of them, because they have like no hitbox, so just having a ton of them, they can kind of stack on top of each other. I guess when they're kind of like stacked on top of each other, you can't really knock them back, so it actually makes Frozen Orb better when they're in really close proximity like this. Dude, I don't... Level 140? So great. Dark shapes. The darkest of shapes. I mean, it's good that we can take them out. Like, it's a little slower than I would like, but this has got to be the fastest. Yeah, like, look at this. These drops are very satisfying. Okay, let's get another big cluster. A unique. Always like getting a unique. Probably slightly less so with the changes I've made to rares, but, you know, uniques are still really cool. And I still think unique charms and unique jewels are probably just always going to scale up way better than rares. And like, of course, like Xyle artifacts are impossible to compare. Like, they're just going to be better. How are we for space? Oh, we're doing fine. Well, there's my first druid skill, so definitely, after I've said a million times I need to pick a jewel, I definitely need to pick a jewel now. It's just going to be so hard to beat the efficiency of a jewel. Like, so granted, I was a very high level, like level 3000 on my assassin, but I had a jewel that was like plus 15 to all skills and then like plus 40 assassin skills. And I mean, getting that on a jewel, that's just so unbeatable. You need to be juicing a jewel, because that level of power is up there. I think we needed Mickey Head. Did we need Genie Head? We might have. Oh, okay. I just don't have two spaces right next to each other. And now I am full. That's bad. I don't care about that. That's bad. I don't care about that. Confuse when you kill. Yeah. I think I really want, like, any other skill tree would have been better than that. Yeah, because this is just giving me the two reanimates, but I'm not even getting the reanimates because of the slain monster's rest in peace. So, I need to get rid of that. But yeah, those aren't good enough. Decrepify, that's interesting. Don't care about that, I don't care about that. I don't care about that. I don't care about that. I'll keep thought. It's a unique. 89% faster hit recovery. That's not nothing. One to all skills, one to clay golem. Is one to all skills better than this? I mean, this is just the reanimates, and then I don't have to feel scummy about, because I don't think I actually have any other reanimates anywhere. Oh, I have this. 22% chance. Well, they're all blind. The experience is just so wild. Okay. Was Dry Hills good? Oh yeah, Dry Hills has Growlies. Growlies have pretty high quality drops. Good for elixirs and poster fragments. Players 8 might be a little too much. I might lower it to players 5 for a little bit, just until we can get some more damage. Okay, we're gonna start dumping these in here. We're clearly picking up a lot. Yeah, I can't move. Not great. I actually killed some stuff here. Man, 8 meters is just a short. Okay, we do actually, I'm gonna stream for about 2 hours, so I was gonna say, we do actually have a good little bit of time here, you know, about a half hour, 20 minutes, where I will be able to get some nice farming in. So, we will do a couple runs of the Rocky Ways. Now, my understanding is your stats are supposed to improve your spell damage. I don't actually think that it works. All right, we're at 4830. If I put 100 points in, yeah, we're still 4830. And I know the fix for that. I'll have to ask UGF if that's something he wants. I could fix that. Okay, we're gonna rejoin. Get out of my face. Two. Surprising number of threes. I'm not mad. Throw all our chipped gems in here. Then we go to page 1 and do that, and then fanaticism. That's interesting. So we don't need the conviction. What would be the next best aura? Because if we have Merc with level 10 conviction, that would take a long time to get level 10 conviction on the Skillpedia. I mean, if vigor gave move speed, I would actually use vigor. If meditation gave damage, I would use meditation. But neither of those statements are true. All right, we'll plop that down there, plop that down there. Hydra Windstruck. I mean, kind of cool. It's probably not very good. Kim Heart Fragment. Yeah, that's the super common one. Our Demon Key there. Put that there. Dump the ones we don't care about. Well, this is actually okay. I would keep that. Kinds of ones, and then that's for a Merc Jewel, that's for a Merc Jewel, this is for whatever. Okay, we did have Mickey Feet. Darn it, darn it. We got a bunch of Mickey Feet. Okay. Okay. Oh, okay. But we got the Mickey head. Look at that. And yeah, we got Genie as well. Okay. Cold skill damage. I'll take it. $241 extra gold. I'll take it. Okay. So now I think we can get rid of this thing. 12 mana after each kill is just not relevant anymore, especially because my main damage is Hurricane. So that's gone. This is 100 magic find. However, you know, I gotta be honest. Let's look at this. Yeah, I have 500 magic find. Getting 92 in 6 slots is not worth it to me anymore. So that's going. I still want the stats there. Yeah, like, this is the same magic find basically in a smaller package, so better. We don't need that anymore. Let's drop that. It's fine. Anything else that matters? What do we need for Garfield? We need Garfield feet. I think that's our second Manny piece. Yeah. Like that. Yep. Go like that. I think players 5 will hopefully just increase how quickly we kill these things. And I kind of think that's all that matters here. We should still get stuff. getting chunks of experience. I'm not gonna pick up six gems anymore. I don't think that's like I have enough. I think I picked up a lot on that last run. I mean, I got a lot on the last run, like just a ton drop. I'm not gonna pick up jokers anymore either. Happen if you tried to make set jewels. I don't know if that would really work. I don't know if jewels ever really count as being equipped. I don't know. I am surprised that they give so much experience. Kind of crazy to me. I'll look at the Hex Charm. It's probably not gonna be up to par. But hex charms are fun. I do have them set up to theoretically give much better skills. Shout an Ancient's Call on kill. Like, that's cool. Wrangle them all up. Oh, just gaining some levels. 176. Throw out the Grand Charm. So, like, what's probably going to wind up happening is, just like with my Paladin, I'm going to wind up farming in Act 2 until, like, level 300, and then I'm going to move forward, and then my guess, because my Paladin was, I think I was in Act 2. I don't think I even beat Duriel with my Paladin. But I was, like, level 300, and I wanted to do the random affixes. So I did the random affixes, and I was like, I gotta start a new character. So my guess is that there is something that awaits me that is significantly harder than Venom Drakes in the Cold Plains. I mean, maybe that's the worst. And that would actually be kind of disappointing that there's not, like, another significant challenge like that. I mean, I certainly don't want it to be impossible. Venom Drakes in the Cold Plains are rough. But it could have been worse. Okay, there's the edge. Alright, so there's a run. And I think we'll be able to do one more. I'm gonna really try to hold this stream to about 2 hours long. Okay, thanks, Kane. That's kind of expensive, but, you know, you gotta pay it. I mean, it's not bad, it's just not interesting. I didn't realize that I had picked up a couple jokers. I thought I had sworn off the jokers for good. Well, we got a lot of rabbit middles. Do we have rabbit's head somewhere? No. Just a ton of rabbit middles. Okay. Get another rabbit going. Why am I not seeing? Sandstorm on striking. No, that's a three. Okay, a lot of threes, always a good problem to have. I can't read. What was that? 67 all attributes. Man. I mean, that would be a perfectly fine base. 51 all attributes. Typically, I find myself wanting to use a jewel that already has stats on it that I would want. Lifesteal and all attributes are already things that I would put on a jewel. The poison damage is kind of whatever. But the rest, I think, is good. So I think I might do that. Rare, rare. 1% reanimate as Wyvern. We'll use that as a base. I feel like that's very safe. I could use this maybe for a Merc Jewel. Just because the two maximum resists, eventually I'll probably put those on a Merc Jewel. It'll basically be damage. Because mercenaries don't get nearly as much from, like, there's way fewer ways to scale them compared to players. This is, like, actually kind of bad. Oh, I could put that. I could make that a Merc Jewel, right? Fire, lightning, cold damage. Oh, wait, no. I was going to do this one. Right? I'm also going to test that remove RIP. I think it's three keys and any item. Yep. Good deal. Then I will do the same on my helmet. A lot of set items. Okay. So, well, maybe I want to do two, because one I can do the elemental damage on. Yeah, I think I actually like that better. Yep, still getting a bunch of Cathan's stuff. Oh, right. Let's put Cathan's with Cathan's. Maybe that's a good idea. Kingtail thread, kingtail fragment, more Cathan's. And Irathas. That's our first Irathas piece. And not our first Sanders piece. It's supposed to be purple, but they didn't get colored in 1.10, I guess. Or maybe just Zio. Anything we don't care about. Yeah, like, these, I could theoretically stack a bunch of them onto here and just start getting a pile of Ellie damage. Don't know if it really matters. But yeah, right now this is the stuff I would put on a Merc Jewel, and that's like mostly Fizz stuff. So I'm gonna put this here. And here, and then I think we will what do we have? One druid skills. One druid skills and 15% move speed. So yeah, we're gonna wait. That's not actually worth doing anything with yet. Let's check here. I am interested in a charm. Well, we don't have, we got nothing. You know what I could do? I could probably, I'm just gonna test this. I don't know if this is actually gonna work. But if I can kill Venom Drake on a higher player's count, which it doesn't look like I can yet, but if I could, right, I could farm level 90 drops. Yeah, they are just insane. We've got another slain monsters rest in peace somewhere. Seeing it, but I'm feeling it. Dude, but actually, like, what the heck? So I don't. So now I actually get my reanimate. Which I don't know if that's actually gonna help me kill any faster. Especially because it's gonna keep the dark shapes more dispersed. But, I mean, they did a non-zero amount of damage, could be helpful. I guess I don't really need the heat kept off of me, so... it's kind of whatever. Hurricane if I'm trying to deal non-zero amounts of damage. Experience is way chunkier when you have an experience shrine, that's for sure. To absolutely nobody's surprise. Thank you. So, yeah, we are, like, encroaching on 200, which is real good. For me, actually playing a caster and not abusing summons, that's really bad. 106 Lightning Absorb. Level 25 lower resist. This is middle Yu-Gi-Oh. We're still missing the middle to this, I think. Alright, I'm gonna be done after this clear. So, not a lot longer. Well, I mean, it's nice to have Act 1 out of the way. I mean, it took like 8 hours, but got there. I feel like there's a pretty marked difference between doing this on player's 8 and doing it on player's 5. I feel like I got way more fragments on 8. Could just be entirely anecdotal, but that's what it felt like. Like that first run, felt like I filled up my inventory with stuff from one run. Anything? Nope. Ton of duplicates. Real shame. There is a cube recipe that lets you go 3 of any fragment to a random fragment. I'll probably start using that after, you know, another couple of runs here. What's kind of interesting, also kind of frustrating, but kind of interesting, that poster fragments are differentiated presumably by like monster level, and so different areas of the game will have a propensity for dropping different fragments, and so you can't just get all the fragments running like, you know, Cold Plains, right? You do wind up having to farm a lot of different areas. Alright, we've got this little area left.
Thank you.
You take those. Crowd. Hydro Windstruck, Sandstorm Windstruck. That's cool. -2% enemy poison resistance. No, I'm not gonna use that. Yeah, this is cool. I wish I could give it to my mercenary, but I can't, so we will drop it. It's like, look at all those duplicates. So disappointing. Else in my inventory that's duplicates. Everything in my inventory is a duplicate of one that I have, but not duplicates of each other. And actually, that was slice of apple, right? Yeah, slice of apple. So that's a better cube scroll that they call uncommons. The ones that I picked up, these are commons, then you've got uncommons, then there's secret, which are like orange, I think, and then there's arcane. Okay. Well, that's very good, for like a merc jewel, right? 62 all attributes is a lot. I guess they don't really gain a lot of benefit from attributes, though. Because I kind of want to see what slice of apple is. 10% faster run walk. Surprisingly bad. Okay. We're calling that the clear. So that will be it. But hey. Oh, let's just gain a level real quick. Hardly got to do anything here. We finish Act 1, we hit level 198, we are really, really kind of cruising forward here, so we'll get the inventory dumped out. It's a lot of this. I guess this gives me, two of the duck. Right, we just need his head now. Yeah, I do. Yeah. We'll get in a 10-10-10 before we're done.
I'll take Mel out of your way.
Okay, thank you.
Come on, Mel.
Yeah. Okay. Real quick. I gotta do a little stretch first. You know, what's funny is since I started streaming, I've actually worked out more than I have in, like, the last 2 or 3 weeks just by doing, like, 20 sit-ups, 20 push-ups, 20 jumping jacks. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it's funny that something that is normally considered, like, super lame and super not good for you, just playing video games has gotten me to exercise more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. Okay. There. It's done. It is done. I don't think we got anything really cool. That's just worse than 2 to druid skills. 2 elemental and 2 summoning is pretty unimpressive. That's kind of cool. But yeah, nothing actually that I care about enough to, like, bother worrying about my inventory right now. Okay. Well, yeah, it is a shame. Oh, I was thinking these two are related, but they're definitely not. Dragon Ball Z and Yu-Gi-Oh! Are 2 very different IPs. We do have another 2 of Mickey there. So we'll plop him down. But, yep, I'm going to call it there. I'll just be done. Otherwise, I'll be putzing around for forever. So, thank you for hanging out. I will be streaming again tomorrow, about the same time. And we'll kind of see where we get from there. I might wind up farming Rocky Waste, right? This area right outside Luco Lane. Might wind up farming that a bit more. But, I mean, we're definitely a high enough level. Really, what I need... We're going to do that. Really, what I need is just more skill levels. I need a Hurricane to be 10,000 damage, probably. And hopefully we can get Frozen Orb up as well. So... Yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you tomorrow.